My name is Donald Northfelt. I'm a hematologist and medical oncologist here at the Mayo Clinic in Phoenix, and I spend most of my time seeing patients in our breast center. I was influenced to do research in my medical career because I have a scientific background. I have an undergraduate degree and graduate degree in geology, which is a highly science-based endeavor. And when I came into medical training and then medical practice, I carried with me the notion that a science-based approach to problems is the best way to solve them. I had many mentors in my training, in my undergraduate years, graduate school, medical school, residency, and fellowship. Too numerous to name, honestly. But what I wanted to mention in answer to your question is that I currently have mentors here at the Mayo Clinic who enrich my life and my perspective tremendously. I want to name a few. One is Dr. Barbara Podgkai, who's a colleague in our breast center. Another is Dr. Karen Anderson, who's a research scientist at Arizona State University, also a physician practicing in our breast center. I also like to call out the fact that the trainees with whom I work, the residents and the fellows in our training programs, inspire me and mentor me in various ways to maintain my enthusiasm and interest for our research endeavors. And I would extend that to our clinical staff here at Mayo. We have very dedicated research staff here who support our clinical trial process. And every day as I work with those folks, I'm inspired to do more and do better. So the question of who are my mentors, it could be answered, I suppose, in a more conventional way, talking about professors with whom I worked and along those lines. But I think I get such tremendous mentorship in the environment of Mayo Clinic where I work that really has to be emphasized. The other person whose name I particularly want to mention is Dr. Matthew Goetz at the Mayo Clinic in Rochester. He's the enterprise-wide leader of our breast cancer clinical research group, and he's an extremely inspiring individual that prods me to do better and to think more about our research agenda here at Mayo. About 2 years ago, I became the Arizona site director for the Center for Health Equity, previously called Office of Health Disparities Research. The specific goals of the Center for Health Equity are to provide opportunities for underserved minorities and other potentially marginalized people to become involved in clinical research. The reason I feel so deeply that this is important is that many of our best treatments for patients with cancer come to us in the form of clinical trial opportunities. There are many cancers for which our current knowledge and our current answers are not satisfactory. By helping patients with these problems engage in clinical research, we're bringing to them the very best, the very latest, the ideas of the brightest scientists all being brought to bear on their problem. In that sense, I feel like a facilitator more than a researcher. I'm trying to pair patients with a need, pair them up with an opportunity in our clinical research agenda to get them what they need. The Center for Health Equity was created at Mayo Clinic because of the realization that too often marginalized folks, people from minority groups, don't have the opportunity to engage in clinical research or engage in clinical trials that could create these advantages for them. So it was a very humbling and a very gratifying feeling for me to try to take a leadership role in bringing clinical trial opportunities to minority group patients. An example of that is our practice at the Phoenix Indian Medical Center, where every week one of the medical oncologists from Mayo travels to provide care to patients with cancer who are registered tribal members in Indian Health Service. It's very gratifying for us to see patients there and be able to offer them the opportunity to participate in clinical trials at Mayo, where they get access to these cutting-edge therapies. We have been particularly focused at Mayo Clinic in Arizona in the last few years on research involving preoperative treatments for breast cancer. This would be either radiation treatments or anti-estrogen treatments or chemotherapy treatments that are given prior to the surgery for the breast cancer. Without going into too much detail, there are many reasons to consider this to be an advantageous approach. And I'm proud to say that at Mayo Clinic Arizona, our surgical collaborators are very invested in this approach to patient care. So all of my surgical colleagues happily refer patients to the medical oncologist to participate in these preoperative treatment clinical trials. We've been able, because of that ethic that our surgeons have, we've been able to make major contributions to enrollment of patients into these preoperative clinical trials. And I think that that's where the future lies in breast cancer care, that preoperative treatments will become absolutely the norm in the future. So I feel that Mayo Clinic Arizona has really been out on the cutting edge of that movement toward preoperative therapy, and that's very gratifying for me. Research gives us hope for the future. Research allows us to think about a time or dream about a time when our treatments are going to be far better than they are today. If I was in a practice where I did nothing but give the same standard treatment day after day to patient after patient, I don't think it would be very gratifying. Working at a place like Mayo Clinic, on the other hand, gives me the opportunity to introduce patients to newer, better schemes for their treatment, oftentimes in the context of our clinical trials. That's rejuvenating for me as a care provider. It's a tremendous opportunity for my patients, gives me tremendous gratification to be part of that system offering better things, tomorrow's strategies, to my patients today.